Would you open that door?
No. No, I wouldn't open the door.
Okay.
I know what's in there. Because multiple beeps. And, you know, I kind of trust the Ewok a little bit. I don't know why. Maybe
they're very cute.
I had a really good weekend with the Ewok once, so I trust the Ewok.
Okay. So do you say something back to her?
Yeah, I'd be like, we've got bombs. It's in the locker of P9L, and there's a lot of beeps coming from here.
What would you do?
Huh. I can't eject this away from the ship.
The gunnery thing, just like eject.
Just like eject the gunnery.
Pull the lever that turns it into just like the escape pod. Later! I have no real connection to any of your characters. Except Yerp is certainly up there.
Oh, well, you know I'm not going to leave Yerp.
Yeah.
I climb out of the gunnery thing. Do we still have fire suppressant droid?
Yeah, you mean Fido?
Yeah.
Yeah, fire dowser unit?
Yes.
Says this little, it's like a little stupid R2, the ones with like the boxy ones with the round heads. Mm-hmm. But both of his, he has two little arms that are both fire extinguishers.
What do you want?
Okay.
It can speak.
Okay.
It's been with the ship a long time.
Ewok hurries over, toddles over to where Maharaja.
Yerp looks very concerned, by the way, as you come up past him off the little.
It's okay. Stay. Stay in your spot. It's okay. Here, have a treat.
It's like, an arm.
Take it off your back.
It's like, I've been carrying it.
Okay.
Yeah. Good boy. So I go to where Maharaja is, mm-hmm. and she's looking at this closet, and my nose is telling me that the closet is the
you
thing.
You smell strong bombs.
Yeah, I kind of feel like there's probably bombs in here. I want one.
If you want to step in as Captain Johns, or Sergeant Johns, you're welcome to at any moment, by the way.
Oh, okay, fair enough. Yeah.
Is he dead yet, or is he groaning? Is Gippy still groaning somewhere as he's being drugged to the hot tub to be cooked?
I think I can think of a more dramatic way to really kill him, so I'm hanging on to that for a second.
Okay,
so he's like just laying there groaning.
I'm
he's groaning and calling out for help, and we're all ignoring him. That sounds right.
My friends.
Just tears.
And when his tears hit the ground, they like hiss.
Yeah.
Basically, your death is coming very soon.
Okay.
I think Gippy's got one dramatic action that he can. That he can pull
Okay, I'll leave that to you.
All right. So whatever that would be.
What's going on back there?
There's a closet full of bombs.
Never have bombs on my ship. We have bomb detectors everywhere.
I know I dropped the bomb when I came out of the closet. Ho!
But you're in immense pain.
That's Sergeant Johns.
That's Sergeant Johns.
Coming out of the bathroom, his went up to the elbows where he just shoved Gippy like under the water. I assume.
Okay, so I'm gonna.
Okay,
my guys are.
You're to the wall door. Yeah. You hear the beeping intensifies. Boop 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 boop.
All right, the beeping is more frequent now. I'm guessing that this is some kind of timer thing. Okay. We need to get this right now.
Some kind of timer thing. Aren't you the professionals?
I'm a professional at killing people, not a professional at defusing bombs.
Is there a gap under the door? Can I get the fire suppressant droid to stick his two little fire suppressant arms under the gap under the door and fill that closet, which I'm imagining is just a closet because it's P9L's room. He didn't need to stretch out or put up posters or anything.
No, he just goes in and turns off.
He just goes in and turns off. He's a droid.
Yeah.
Fill a closet with fire suppressant.
Here's the thing, though. I think sci-fi doors pretty much just slide in and out of walls, so
then
I don't think there's
a gap. How does the air get in?
Why is there gravity on your ship
air,
right
he's
now? Why do droids
imply that Root does have sweet posters on the walls? Like
Root 100% has sweet posters all over the walls.
Are they posters that Root drew herself?
Yes. But they're sweet.
Speaking of Root, Seldon Arcaes? I'm going to go with Seldon Arcaes.
Seldon Arcaes!
What a sweet name, Seldon. Thanks for jumping into chat, man. Gives, or gal, gives Talene. Thanks, man. Mm-hmm. I'm good at this. gives Talene one boost die and says, good luck. You're gonna need it.
Aw.
Yeah. I also have the Bard, 1971, longtime viewer, longtime donator, gives Talene one boost die.
What? Thank you, guys.
So you each have a free-floating boost die you can spend. Remember, you also have a free-floating boost die. That just means if you want to spend it on your next roll or you want to wait on, hold on to it for a little while, you can. Okay.
I'm going to go back to something early in my character, which was that my character would just bang on computers and make them work.
Yeah, you don't get technology.
Dang it.
No, but that was, that's why you would bang on computers.
Right.
I'm supporting you.
So I want to... Kind of. Okay.
Do you need for me to pry open the door a little bit?
Yes, open the door. I will go in. This is a test.
Prying it open just a little
bit.
Okay, we need some other ideas. Okay, I'll pry open the door. Let's do this.
She pries open the door.
And how far are we opening this door?
Just a little bit, so that
Ewok size, sideways just Ewok.
So the
slide in.
Your idea of the fire suppressant droid could get in.
Fire suppressant comes in, I go in. It's time for some banging. I'm just gonna go in and start pulling crap and banging on stuff, which is either gonna blow the ship to hell or it's gonna work out luckily in my favor because I got two boost dies.
The sergeant chases the remote for the collars and just like, where's the kill switch on these things? Jesus.
You know what?
Or space Jesus. It's
Val, by the way, so at this point you've taken off far enough, I think, from the rest of stuff that you can safely like set it and forget it mode. If you want to go back and join these guys, Maharaja, I think just from, you don't quite get all the words that the Ewok is saying, but you are picking up that the Ewok sounds like she wants to go in there and bang on stuff and really go nuts and may not know what bombs are. Or she seems to know what bombs are, but they seem to be spiritual things.
Because I want to run this off of my survival cunningness skill.
Which sounds
I've
great.
I've seen two bombs already.
You're the professional, so this is probably, Oscar, for you, would probably be a skill that you're trained in. Maybe, do you have gunnery? Maybe gunnery for bombs.
Gunnery for bombs?
I would take mechanics, I guess, to disarm things. Probably mechanics for bombs, or if you have gunnery, I would maybe allow that.
Or like warfare,
it's like
maybe?
Ordnance. Warfare, yes, if you're trained in warfare, but I think you're the only person with warfare on your sheet, to be honest. Which makes sense. Anyway, the other thing I should bring up right now is that the bombs are definitely on a timer, and I'm going to need quick action from all of you because I'm going to start counting down.
Okay.
By the time my fingers hit zero, I need to know what you're
gunnery.
Doing.
I think between the two of us, we could just rock this out.
Okay.
I think the both of us do this.
So are you hitting this door open button? Are you opening it a little bit?
We're going. We're going in right now.
Do it.
Open.
Boop. Door opens up. You know that thing people do where they fill their medicine cabinet with marbles in case people look in there?
No.
Like a dozen spherical bombs, grenades, all with like a red flashing light, spill out and start bouncing off the metal floors and rolling across the interior of the
ship. Quit fooling around back there. Switching on autopilot. What is all that noise? And he like stands up and he looks around.
We got roller bombs.
I have a net.
Right as you stand up, a bomb comes rolling past you down here. Oh, you have a net. Let's hear what you do with that.
So. I have a bowling net. As soon as things start falling out, I'm like, it shoots and it catches them.
I need a ranged light.
Ranged light is my jam.
Ranged light's your jam.
Do it.
Yeah. I'm just going to walk. Oh, yes. Okay. I couldn't help but know.
Ranged light. I've got one yellow and two green against.
Against capturing a dozen round rolling bombs.
Let's call with a net.
It's a great idea. So let's give it three purple and a boost. Plus any other boosts you have. And I'm going to spend one of my numerous dark side points to upgrade that.
Oh, no.
So make that a red and two purple.
Oof. I'm going to save one of my boosts because I'm going to, after this, if I catch all these bombs in my net, that's all the bombs, right?
Except one, right? Because one rolled by me, or
that's a good question.
Depends on how good the roll is.
Depends on how good the roll is. Yeah, I think there's a lot of. I think you'll. You could. If it's a success, you'll capture the majority of them.
Okay.
If it's a huge success, you'll get them all.
I'm saving a boost. Okay. All right. Okay. So what I'm rolling then is a yellow, two green, two boost die, two purple, and a red.
Okay.
Come on, baby. Dear
That's
God.
That's despair. Yes. Is it a failure though?
Well.
No.
It's not a failure.
Okay. You have two
advantages,
success.
Three advantage.
But
those three advantage are canceled by those three threat. So all the advantage and threat are canceled because there's three of each.
So it's two success and a despair.
She has a total of three success, but the despair also counts as a failure. So two success, which is a pretty good success.
It's pretty good success.
Yeah.
But it's a despair.
Okay,
so here's what I'm going to rule on that.
Okay.
Net out.
Yeah.
Over them, you like pull them in. These metal balls would come rolling towards you.
And Yerp is also in the deck.
No.
Starts hastily eating the bombs.
I told Yerp to stay in his place.
Yerp is staying in his place. So I think we're looking at. Oh, okay. Here's my despair then.
Oh.
So we get. Boom, 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 boom.
Guys, I'm going to admit I knew that despair was coming. Like I had a feeling in my heart.
Three,
that's gonna be a despair.
Three of the bombs are not captured of the 12.
Yikes.
So you did great.
That's my despair?
You did great.
No, that's not the despair. Caught a lot of bombs.
One of them
that's a lot.
Rolls down the, I think this is your jacuzzi. That looks about right. One of them rolls towards you as you're getting up. So there's just like that sound that a metal ball makes when it's rolling down a metal corridor. Right as you're getting up. And then rolls right past you and then wedges itself underneath the equivalent of the gas pedal on the bottom or whatever, the clutch, whatever it would be down there. The thing you have to push your foot to do, bomb rolls right in there.
Like
underneath,
final
I don't know,
destination.
My ship doesn't have gas pedals. Yeah, obviously you've got the throttle, but they're, you know, the organ stops or whatever it has down there to make the nitro injector. And then that's one. Two, second bomb comes rolling. Does a little U-curve down here, right up next to Yerp.
What?
And up into his hands? Yeah.
Oh!
Yerp eats a bomb!
Yeah, in his mouth. Third one. Boom, tunk, 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 right next to the side of a jacuzzi.
We're giving it, what was it?
Brushes up against.
Goodbye. Thank God, my medicine.
Frothing at the mouth. Trying to shove a bomb.
I will live to see another day.
Boom! This is Gippy parts blast out of the. Wait a minute. Does Gippy eat the bomb, or are we getting ahead of ourselves?
You're the galaxy master.
Well,
here's
all I'm ruling so far is that one of your arms is limply hanging out of the jacuzzi, just dead, and the bomb bumps up against it. Possibly.
Okay.
So that's as far as I'm saying. Okay, so I'm going to need. We have very little time before these bombs explode because you were being cautious before they went off, which was smart, but not in this case, because I'm an asshole. To disarm,
I do have an idea.
Yeah.
Well, then let's start with you. We'll just go around the table in order, I think, starting with you, and we'll go around. I think you all have a chance to act twice before they explode.
Okay. I'm going to whip out my data pad that accesses computer systems. I'm going to, I know a number of tips and tricks that have helped me out of a tight spot, and I'm going to hack these bombs and shut them down.
Hack the bombs?
Hack the bombs! Because computer systems.
I'm okay with that.
Because they're Wi-Fi bombs.
Yeah, the bombs are obviously connected to each other somehow. That makes sense.
The false Bluetooth.
But here's the question for you. If you want to just target one of the bombs, that'll be pretty easy. If you want to target all three of them, I'm going to make the whole roll much harder.
What about the ones that are in the net? They're no longer... no longer a danger? Because I was kind of thinking it was like a proximity thing, because I was going to try to do the ones that were in the net.
Okay, if you want to do the ones in the net, you have them all, you're right by the net, so I'd make that fairly easy.
Okay.
Okay, if you want to do that, you can shut them all
down. They're the bigger threat right now.
They're all definitely going down.
Heck, the bombs!
Give me a computers check. What do you got in that?
One.
Is it a yellow, just one green?
And a yellow and a green.
A yellow and a green. Okay, so it could be worse. I'm going to do standard difficulty, which is two purple. So just so you guys know what happens when these bombs go off. They're fairly small. They're more like grenades. But if one goes off right next to you, it's going to do a critical wound to you, mm-hmm. which no. does stuff, eventually does things like blow off hands and blind you or whatever.
Yikes.
They also will do some damage. It may not be enough damage to kill you outright, but you will not be happy, and it might light you on fire. Just so you guys
especially
know what's going
if you're
on.
Covered in fur.
yeah, very flammable.
Okay.
I'm going to use one of the destiny things.
So the way we do that, that sounds great. Go ahead and flip that over. And we need a cheers, because we should all, at the very least, cheers when we flip it over.
Let's do this.
That sounds pretty damn good. Okay, Maharaja, you come striding out. You flip out your data pad.
So you get to take a yellow and take out that green.
Oh, yeah. Okay. That's exactly right. So you're going to roll two yellow against two purple.
Okay.
Also, I think that was a really clever idea, so I'm going to give you a boost die.
Yeah.
But it is, yeah, that's fine. Let's go with that. Okay. This is a pretty shitty situation to be in.
Hack the bombs!
Hack the planet. Oh, it's a failure.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
a ton
no.
of advantage, though.
Oh,
ton
that's
of
a great
advantage.
Point. So one success, one failure. Those cancel each other out. If there are nothing, no successes on the roll, it is a failure.
So
you have to have at least one success.
So three advantage.
So three advantage is a lot of advantage, which means something really advantageous happens that is not the bombs being disarmed.
It gives us a lot more time.
Yeah, yes. You didn't even have to say that. Before the bombs were like do 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 do, now they're like dirt.
Oh, okay, great. Okay, great. So totally, you pull up your pad and you manage to get into the
dirt.
Tooth. Yeah, and there's no way to turn it off, and you can't do it. But then you get into the subroutine where it's like number of seconds before you explode, and it's like nine, and you go like 9999999.
Yes.
Okay, that's
Hack
awesome.
The bombs.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll have another.
So
beer.
They slow down, but they're still volatile things. Yeah. So you don't want to hit them with a hammer necessarily.
Or bank on them.
Talene.
Which was my plan.
Mm-hmm. You're
okay.
Up.
Thank you.
So you turn around in slow motion as you hear that. Yerplik's happy.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. The good news is that we've already established from the Rancor vomit perfume incident.
Oh, goodness.
That I can get Yerp to vomit on command.
Yes, we have established that. I forgot that we had established that. You have that level of...
Yes, I forgot. I'm also sorry we established that.
No, Rancor Ambergris became part of the narrative.
I'm glad I'm not the only person bringing the toilet humor to this. Anyway, continue.
Go on. So you can, yes, so you can help him vomit on demand. I had totally forgot that, but you're absolutely right.
Give it to me. Release.
Did you say
release
Gippy?
Everything? Release. Everything. You got an arm. Give me that.
Oh, he does see the arm. Okay, I need a survival check because that is the skill you use for influencing animals.
Mm. Yes.
Which I think you're reasonably good at. You're trying to make him. Well, he said everything, so that's fair. Oh, this has been a very scatological game. So go ahead and give.
It's like Star Wars.
It's just like Star Wars.
You made him swallow a bomb. I'm
just too purple.
Not sure how else I was supposed to get it. I guess if it's 99999, I could wait till it came out the other end, which would still be scatological.
Yeah, I know. What can we do?
Yeah.
And it wouldn't be pleasant for the Rancor. So let's do. What do you guys think? How difficult do you think it is to make a Rancor vomit on command?
I've never tried.
I've never tried either.
I had to once. It wasn't pleasant.
Okay, let's
once.
Let's just call it two, I never want to do it
two
again.
Two purple because we have established this is something you can do. Oh, how about this? Three purple, but I'll give you a boost because it's something we've established you can do.
I mean, like, right. Dogs throw up and eat it all the time. Like, it shouldn't be that big a deal for these Rancors.
Good point. Take a second boost because they probably throw up and eat their own vomit all the time. Yeah.
Probably.
They do. They're Rancors.
Yeah. I mean, he just ate an arm whole. Like, he just swallows those bones, comes right back up, he eats them again, comes right back up. That kind of thing.
Yeah, that's how it works. Forsaken weighs in. and give me 3 rerolls.
What?
And he says, may the farce be with me.
Okay, so I'm rolling 3 yellow, 1 green, 3 purple, and 2 boost die. 4. Triumph.
Yeah. Oh my god, you crushed that.
Woo. I crushed it so hard.
But there's threat on it, which I love.
Yeah. So it's.
Rank or vomit deactivates bombs?
Rank or fluid seem to be miraculous.
They really do.
They heal you, they deactivate bombs. Yeah, it's already dissolved in his stomach.
3 success. 1 threat and a triumph.
Great, so in this situation, we, success, he vomits up the bomb.
Yes.
Enough! Enough! He goes, no, but then you start giving him a little tummy rub.
I roll up newspaper and I tap him on the nose with it.
Puts his face right down to the ground. And like the slime covered like bomb comes out, still beeping.
Yeah.
It's very similar to the inaugural address.
And like the slime is hanging from his chin still.
Good boy.
Do you want to tell me what your triumph is first, or do you want to hear what your threat is first?
I'd like to hear what my threat is first.
Gosh, oh man. No, I'll go easy one. You just take a point of strain.
Okay.
As the acidic juices of the Rancor pool around your feet, and it's just not wonderful.
No, of course not.
Okay. So that's fine. That's easy. It's 1 threat. Mm-hmm. It's fine. Okay, triumph.
What this triumph represents is that through this series of commands and exchanges between me and Yerp, our level of communication has leapt to a higher point where basically now it's like we're psychically linked.
You're,
I can now command him with a glance. And he knows exactly what I want.
Okay, you've successfully.
As long as he is in eye or smell sight of me.
Okay, I like that.
He knows what I want and he will do it.
Okay, I like that.
Wow, that's very Ranger of you.
Yeah, very, very good. Okay, sounds good. Good use of that triumph. I like it. What a good way to level that up. Okay, and so he vomits it up.
Yeah, and then we look at each other.
The two of you guys look at each other.
And there's like, there's a music that only we can hear. And it's like real woodsy and tribal, because that's our kind of jam.
Nub, nub.
But it's like with flutes and like sticks on sticks.
Okay. And Europe gives you like a big like, I don't know, he's got the slime all coming down his chin, but he gives you like big Europe hug.
Yeah, yeah.
Like dog hug where he just like flops his big head onto and it's his slime comes onto. And that's where you get your point of strain where you're like, ah. And then like your fur starts to sizzle a little bit. Yeah. Cut over to from your celebration and that's fine. Cut over to from your celebration to Val.
This thing is really wedged.
Down there.
Underneath.
So, yeah, like right in the back, like if a orange rolled underneath your gas pedal got jammed way back.
Oh,
up.
No. Mm.
Yeah. Space gas. Well, it's not my ship. I'm going to kick the side of the gas pedal to try to break it off, because I don't need the gas pedal.
The other guy does. Okay, yeah, that's right. Okay,
you're
great.
You're piloting.
You're good.
So, yeah, how about, that sounds good. If you're just trying to break the ship, I'll tell you 1 purple mechanics check. But it'll give you a setback die to all future piloting checks. For your duration of time on this ship. Does that sound good?
Percussion mechanics.
Percussion mechanics, absolutely. So just 1 purple is all. And you know what? I'm going to flip over 1 of my dark side points to make that purple into a red. Ooh. That's what I can do when I flip them over, is I can make your roll. Oh, you did it already. Great. And that's it. Just to see if your percussion mechanics have unintended consequences.
Should I use the boost die?
What do you got?
You could do something.
I'm piloting in this. I should know.
Yeah.
Okay. Success with an advantage, 2 success and an advantage total.
Ooh, thanks for using that boost day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, no threat or anything. Crunk, breaks off. Grab the bomb. And do the thing to turn it off.
No, it's I don't need to turn it off if they, it's delay like the rest of them.
It's like going to blow up in like a week. Yeah, that's true.
We just have to get them off the ship or use them for something else.
That's what I'm thinking. What else can we blow up?
Cut over to the jacuzzi room.
Okay, so I'm still doing Gippy. All right.
Wait, or I still have an advantage or just a success?
Oh, you do have an advantage. That's right. So I'm sorry. Thank you. Something advantageous happens.
Okay, it bent to the side, pushed the, the bomb out, and just pops right back into place. Not broken at all.
Well played, Troy. Well played.
Now that's a pirate.
I like it. Yeah. Yeah. However that worked out. I love it. Yeah. Or you break it off and you're like, yeah, but that just snaps back on. That's fine.
The bomb is now your gas pedal. Would have been the despair.
Cut to the jacuzzi room. So you are still in control of the captain, if you'd like that.
Okay.
And that's important for because a couple things trigger right now.
Oh.
One, Darth Sci-Fi Trex would like Gippy to eat the bomb. And donate an additional amount of money for it.
Oh my gosh.
To make that happen.
That's fine.
Someone's blowing up.
Second,
if I know Darth Sci-Fi Trex, like either that, I like that I just have a cyber enemy though.
Second, BSB Care.
BSB Care.
Hey, BSB. BSB. Everyone's character, he triggers, everyone's character shifts to the right. So as you reach down to eat the goth bomb, Gippy.
Oh, no.
Gippy is now going, all of you guys are suddenly hit as, I don't know, is it the captain panics or something like that? It hits the button.
It's just like... It's like, Rengar puke doesn't solve this problem. Like, I need some competency. Get me the fish guy. I don't know.
You guys all at the same time feel this sharp prick, and then, like, you're lightheaded for a second, and then, whoa! Okay, so to the right. Yeah, so we pass this down. So, Troy, you are now voicing Gippy Bindu. So the concept that I had in mind for this was that you're still, as your character, as you, as the player, are trying to... play this character as true to the character concept as you are aware.
Okay, but we're still ourselves in this character.
Yes.
Are we just playing the character?
So I think have to do the voice and everything?
Not necessarily.
So did Gippy's brain go into Val's body, Val go into Gippy's body?
That's such a good question. The way I had envisioned this working out is that I'm going to ask each of you to essentially role play the other person's character. So,
we're not aware that we're the actual
character. The
characters.
I got it.
Yes.
Congratulations. You get to be awesome.
Val, pal. This is not as good as my ship. My ship is better than this ship.
So all of a sudden your characters are not quite themselves, that they seem to be acting in a way that's kind of like how they usually act, but it's not quite right. That's the idea.
Oh, dear.
And we'll switch back at the end of the scene, I think.
Oh, dear. Okay.
To see how it goes. But alternatively, our minds switch between our bodies.
Okay.
That seems like it might be more fun. So I think let's do that instead.
Okay.
I think let's do that. Sorry, just I had not thought of that originally, but
Raja arrives in Gippy's body that is eating a thermal detonator, a bomb.
Yes, and yes, I actually think that's going to be way
better. And Raja is covered in acidic saliva and is in a tiny furry body.
Furry body. Yeah.
Yeah, so that's a good point. And so at the end of the scene, our minds are going to snap back, so I think that makes sense. So even if Gippy's body dies, Maharaja will still be alive.
Okay.
Yeah. Or whoever's in your body right now.
All right.
Okay. Does that make sense? So Gippy's mind, just for the viewers and for me, Gippy, your mind, suddenly you blink once, you're like floating in a tub, trying to shove a bomb into your mouth. You blink twice, and all of a sudden you are a powerful Twi'lek with some heavy weaponry and a Mandalorian body armor.
My God, what am I doing? But the sensory like feel. Why is this arousing to me? What's wrong with this friggin' Moncal people? I think I can hack this thing.
So I'm gonna roll.
Wait, no, you're Gippy. No. Sorry, I changed my mind. You're Gippy in her body.
Oh, I am. Okay.
So you're in a different body. You're not even involved in the body.
Okay, so
and
whoop, and where's Rasha at this point?
I'm standing next to a bunch of bombs, like in the net. I have the data pad in my hand, and I just.
Oh, I suddenly feel so vivacious and full of vim and vigor. And these all look delicious.
I was going to say the donation is that you want to eat a bomb. So,
I just start taking like the different bombs. like a snake.
Oh, curse my slender and fit esophagus.
Okay, so yeah, that's wonderful. So Maharaj drops to her knees and starts trying to get bombs out and shove them into her mouth.
Oh, God.
So whose body are you in now?
Would be in.
So Troy's
in
mind.
Gimpy.
Sorry,
Gimpy.
Val's mind is now in Gimpy's body. So Val, all of a sudden, the world becomes. You blink, you're like, hey, so, I fixed that, no problem. You blink again.
Picks up the bomb and he like tosses it and catches it, and now he's in someone else's body with it in his face.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, exactly right.
And it's a body in the process of having a heart attack.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. My body is so much better than this. What is going on?
So you, all of a sudden, the world becomes blurry and indistinct through your cataracts. Sensation is numbed. You, everything is, like, the sounds are just, like, all washed out. And your body just feels, well, you're floating in water, so you feel weightless and great. But your heart is seizing up.
This is why I don't pilot anyone else's ship.
So I'm gonna let you guys think about what you're gonna do too. I just wanna get straight what everybody's character is. So Talene, you are now in charge of who?
I'm now in
charge of
Val's body.
So your little Ewok are now suddenly.
I'm like towering up here and I'm like, ah!
You almost fall over immediately.
Exposed skin?
Yeah, your arms are like three times as long as you're used to. Mm-hmm. You're three times as tall as you're used to being. Yeah, it'd be bizarre.
Yeah.
You feel, you're like, it's like if we all of a sudden were in a giant's body.
Yeah.
Okay. That's weird. Okay, and then finally, you are covered. We covered you already, Maharaja. You are now being clutched by a massive Ewok who's drooling all over you.
Oh, Rancor.
Rancor.
Yeah.
You're the Ewok.
And like that time that it was like, oh, it was unpleasant when I had to get a Rancor to like, you know, throw up, I have an intense, like, phobia of rancors. And I'm freaking out.
Don't show fear in front of them. That's the worst.
It's right here. I'm freaking out and I'm trying to fight with my little arms.
So would Europe be connected to Root's body and smell? And would still be, it would be like confused, but be like, I'm only gonna follow Root, or would Root know that your brain is now in somebody else's body, even though it smells and looks and sounds different? I feel like he would follow your orders.
Yeah, follow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I think that if you try to fight with him, like he's just gonna think it's the games we always play. And he's gonna be like.
Wait. So you slowed down all the bombs, so that threat's removed. You added the counter, except I think you said it was proximity based. And I think the one that rolled into the jacuzzi is still active. So the one you have is not like, you have this knowledge now from the front of the ship where it was going boop, boop. The one you have in your hand is going boop, 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 boop. There's these two red lights that are starting to like circle each other and get closer and closer.
How long was I passed out? This is awful.
Yeah, and your massive like soggy hand. Weird. Okay, so what would you do? You have a live bomb. You guys are all who you are. I don't think any of you know that there's a live bomb in your jacuzzi. And you're having a heart attack.
Yeah.
That seems unfair right now to kill you.
What?
No, it's very fair.
The audience has spoken.
The audience has spoken. Okay, so you have one heroic action you can make before your heart bursts in your chest.
Mechanics, make a new heart out of a bomb.
You could, I guess we established you could eat it.
I mean, you could look at your skill list as you would. Because he's higher level.
I could roll the dice and just bang it up against the side of the jacuzzi again.
That's very fair.
I like banging things.
That could work.
Well, it is your turn. Unless anyone else, I guess you're all aware of this weird thrashing. Captain Johns or Sergeant Johns is feeling very good about this. Is there anything any of you guys would do? So I think you're tangled in with the Rancor right now.
Yeah, I've got Rancor right here in my face. I'm just like,
and your plague is like playing with you, so he just like shoves you to the ground and as you pin beneath like, his claws. Yeah. Like reaching giant foam hand towards your face. You're in the cockpit, lights are blinking around you everywhere, you're shooting through space. You run back or you would jump in the pilot seat. There's a bomb next to you, but it's basically been disarmed.
I would turn to run back.
Okay.
Because when you look, I'm not the pilot.
If you turn and you look back, then you do see that Maharaja is trying to fit bombs into a mouth. Yep. Just managed to almost.
Yes. What can I do for you?
I know that's a bad idea.
These vitamin pills are amazing.
Run towards Maharaja / Skippy.
Okay.
Which I think, like, this bigger body is going to be harder for me to control.
You keep running into walls and stuff.
Yeah, I'm like, And when I get there, I'm just going to slap the bomb out of her mouth. His mouth.
What are you doing? My heart's about to explode. Wait. I don't feel like my heart's going to explode. Just even licking one of these things seems to have amazing properties. More!
What, would you say anything to him?
No.
I'm screaming in the background. And I'm just like,
I just want to hear your Ewok voice come out of Val's mouth.
Right, of course. Why are you so crazy?
Right. Crazy? I'd be crazy not to.
Okay, so that's
five
happening
credits.
Right, you're Wait. Pinned to the ground, and that's yeah. happening right over your head.
This is a Twilight with tentacles.
Head tendrils, yeah.
I'm gonna grab the head tendrils and pull them back. You stop it now! You stop it, you go to your place!
What a new and amazing sensation.
Get off of me! Get off of me now!
I don't think I can take any more vitamins at this point.
Doesn't sound like any help is coming to the jacuzzi room. Okay, so you've got a split second to act before this thing blows up. So you've got your one heroic action before this bomb goes off in the jacuzzi room.
No, I don't. Just all nasty and slippery, just
trying
to hurry up and get out of the jacuzzi.
Begging for death. Why is this bomb taking so long?
Okay, so can I do something on my turn?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. If anyone has something
I would like
to
roll, like to roll, right? That's what we're trying to do?
Yeah, roll a dice roll?
Yes.
Yeah, of course.
For okay. what? Is it to eat things?
You slapped them out of my mouth.
I did.
Yes.
You pulled on my leku, and now I'm kind of like snapped in it. And then I see the most beautiful creature I've ever seen in my life crawling out of the jacuzzi. I'm just like, my word, it's like, that beautiful being is in distress. Something must be done. And then, like, do I have any of Raja's knowledge?
Yeah, or your combat skills?
You should still be holding my
data
pad, too.
Okay,
yeah,
you've got
all of her skills.
I have all of her skills, yeah. So I could use mechanics. Or is there any sort of, like...
Medicine?
Medicine, yeah.
This is so...
There are stim packs.
You do have stim packs.
Okay. Okay, so I'm going to use my turn to try and stabilize Gippy with a stim pack.
Okay.
Or medicine roll, whatever you want.
I'll take medicine.
Okay, because it's too green. So what's the difficulty?
I think you'd be the ultimate expert on this. How hard would it be to...
Oh, extremely difficult.
So it'd be four, you want to say four purple or five purple? Five is as hard as it gets.
Okay, let's do four purple.
Okay.
Let's do three purple and one red, because that seems to have a better chance of something more interesting happening.
Okay, so it's an extremely difficult roll to try and get your heart started again.
All right, can I flip over a light side point to give myself
absolutely.
A yellow dye? Sorry to use it on this. Seems a little selfish,
As you see, Maharaja, as you see your body rushing towards Gippy's body, your knowledge of bombs still remains, and you realize that there's this bomb still in the room right behind him that your body is running towards.
Okay.
Ooh, yeah, that snaps me out of it.
Sure, and if she's got root sense of smell,
yeah, then I definitely... Yes.
Ooh, despair. Well, it might be too late, Maharaja, unfortunately. That despair comes up, and it's a failure. It's a failure. with no advantage or threat, and it's a despair.
So what I was trying to do was save
Gippy
Bindu. Okay. I wasn't trying to deactivate a bomb.
Did he just kill me?
No, I know you weren't. So what do you do to your body that you just, when you're trying to start his heart, but you rolled the despair? I don't think you're dead, but it's
okay, so, I mean, you generally determine the despair, so, again, this is like an attempt.
Oh, yeah, it's up to me. Okay, great.
There's an attempt to do a medicine roll.
It's a total, so it's a fail, so you
I'll give you a suggestion, but...
You do not start his heart, so Maharaja runs over to start Gippy's heart. And you don't know the strength of this new body now? And Gippy's bones are like...
Well, the thing is like, it's spaghetti. Just Gippy in her body. Maybe doesn't have any medical knowledge whatsoever, so just, like, has the blaster, thinking it's a medical device.
Yep, okay, that works. That works for your one heroic action of standing up and getting up the bath.
Thank you.
The twilight comes running over.
Shoot you.
I like to imagine you still run like Gippy would move. So in this, the athletic, yeah, twilight's body.
Oh my god.
I'll save you.
Not knowing, so you're like, one of these is the stim pack. You say, right. Looking at the gun and the stim pack, the syringe and the gun, man. And you're like. Not used to seeing so clearly. Probably this one. Right in the heart, right?
I would like to think that it's. I would like to think that it's more in the genitals section.
Why?
The heart's already going, right?
Yeah, that's
like,
right.
That's, again, terrible, no medical knowledge whatsoever. It is a great. Despair and a failure.
So Maharaja, Gippy and Maharaja's body shoves the blaster pistol into Gippy's genitals and fires.
Wait!
Blam!
What? Am I able to do anything? Because, like...
That despair, so that's not my despair. I think okay. That's fine for the despair. Yeah, if you have one...
pretty high in court. Okay. I was going to say coordination, which is an agility, right?
It's
okay.
Great. I think at this point, though, the bomb's overdue. So you do manage to squeeze out of the Rancor's grip, and the Rancor's like, just as blam, as Kippy's destroyed genitals.
Goes right back into the room he was trying to get out of.
And then there's an explosion behind you. Out of from the room there.
Why wouldn't there be?
Flame roasts Gippy's body. It also is going to strike your body, which is currently yours. So you're going to take 8 points of damage.
Am I? I have pretty high soak and
She's
armor.
She's wearing that armor.
Yeah, I have a soak value of 4, so.
So you're going to take 4 points of damage.
Okay, not too bad at all.
Does that include this padded armor that's... Wait, already included in the soap bag.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, not too bad. So
you're
luckily
an 8.
You,
that's nothing.
That was a good body to have run into that room and take a blast. Unfortunately, you are, however, going to take a critical injury. Ooh. So, where's my other d10? There it is. Thank you. And I'm going to let you, Maharaja, roll it for yourself. So okay. I have a chart here, critical injury chart, and this is just going to be...
You want to roll low.
We're going to see what this damage does to you.
Hey, it's going to happen either way.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Yeah.
The things got insane.
Ugh.
9. That's extremely
nice
low.
That's low.
Okay.
A 0-0 on the other one.
So that you're concussed by the blast of the
I've been concussed
bomb.
Before.
It knocks you to the bottom of the initiative order, or you are concussed.
Does it just like be like ejects Gippy's soul into the ether to be dead for all time?
I do think I do think we end that so that you fall. Your body falls unconscious.
Yeah.
Wham! Hits the ground. We do POV from you, blinking, looking over at your own dead body next to you, roasted, genitals shot off. eyes blink,
is
eyes
that
close.
Good enough for you, Darth Sci-Fi Tracks? All right.
Laying there, just smelling delicious.
You get what you pay for, yeah, over the odds.
Yep. Hey, he's basically seafood, right?
Right.
Eyes blink, eyes close, black. Next scene, we open up. All you guys have terrible headaches, and you're all back in your own bodies.
Oh, man.
That is a fun donation.
What a headache I had.
No, I'm kidding.
That's weird, right, guys? All right.
Okay, I'm fine.
Gippy's body is...
Roasted nicely?
Would any of you
Great eat job. It? We don't even have to cook them now. Dig in.
Totally going to eat it.
Root wood.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So Root does.
And the sergeant seems to share a lot of Gippy's own... strange pleasures as well. So yeah, he's clearly wanting to eat the body. So yeah. So I guess the question is
kicking the crap out of it.
Yeah, you in particular. So not only do you have a terrible headache, but you also have a giant lump on your head, and it just is very tender whenever you touch it from your concussion. Yeah, and the lights are a little too bright for you right now.
Was that four under wounds or strain or
wounds?
Wounds, right. And the other important thing to make a note of is every time you take a critical wound, they accumulate. So there is true death in this game, and unlike like D&D or something, there are no spells that bring you back to life. When you get cut in half by a lightsaber, you're cut in half by a lightsaber, and that's the end of the game. So the way that plays, well, for you. So, or when your genitals get shot off and you get blown up in a bomb and people donate to kill you, and you roll a despair.
They wanted him dead so bad, but,
oh. Yeah, so in this case, each time you get a critical wound, we add 10 to your dice roll whenever you take another critical wound. And if you get over 100 on a roll at some point, you die for real.
Okay.
So it's good to know.
So I had a 0-0 before. Was it then?
Basically, we're just going to add 10 to your next time you take one of these.
Take a wound.
We should have added you can pay $5 to also bring Kapi back to life.
Yeah. That's why I double checked with you before you did your donation, but we're okay. No. We're okay. We're on track.
They don't want to do that because I try to kill you.
All right.
What would Sergeant Johnst be doing after? I assume this is, you guys are sitting around the dinner table.
Table? No, we just kneel down to where the body fell.
Okay.
I just, like, go to town.
So, Gippy's body
waits until I get the good parts.
Cracked open like a lobster.
It's just, it's delicious, guys. Like, it's like he makes his own butter.
Oh!
Like, because of all of the extra, like, amber grease in it. It's really delicious.
I bet you would be delicious. P9K and P9M, the two bodyguard droids, are just preparing drawn butter, I guess, in the kitchen. Would Val or Maharaja be feasting upon this old man's corpse?
No, I literally stood up, had a heart attack, and someone shot my genitals off, and then I wake up in my own body again. It's the most dramatic thing ever.
You need to cry for a week.
How would Val be dealing with that? Just piloting?
He quietly goes back and sits back at the ship, leaves it on autopilot, and folds his hands.
Yeah, that makes sense. That really makes sense.
So,
Maharaja.
I'm kicking the crap out of the body. I don't care
that's
if they're
right.
dinner.
Oh, great. Yeah, so you're kicking the hell out of it. How do you feel? Yurp is in the corner and is like hanging out with...
Well, I'm bigger now. I'm back in my own body. So
you got
it's
your
like,
guns and stuff.
It's kind of like if you're small and the boogeyman's real. Yeah. And then like you grow up into an adult and you're like, boogeyman's only this big.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, cool. Yeah, so you're just like, whatever, that's fine.
And I'm like, kicking the body.
And she wasted no time in shooting off my genitals. And she ran and said, ooh, this is going to help.
Blam, 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 boom!
You don't want to be anywhere near her.
Like, it feels like I'm having a heart attack. Ooh.
Like, it wasn't me.
Raj is like, here, let me steer. Don't help me. Don't help me.
Yeah, she's got to come back in and co-pilot here in a minute.
No, she doesn't.
It wasn't me.
Captain Johnst seems uninterested in, after he eats the body, has his fill. Puts a little
it's
more in a little doggy bag.
400 pounds of body, so like this is many meals.
Sure, and it'll probably keep here on the floor. The middle of the room where you guys are feeding like fucking beasts. I love it. Okay. Well, after he's had his fill and he uses his bib, it also has Gippy's face on it. So.
we had that made before we got in the ship.
It's from a popular chain of Mon Calamari seafood restaurants.
Yeah. As soon as he saw Gippy, he was like, yummy.
Yeah, God, apparently. And he's had his fill, and he orders the droids off of the drawn butter duty.
Mm-hmm.
And time to search the ship, basically. Well, fellas, that was a delicious treat. Time to bring this ship in and have it search from stem to stern for information that'll help us track down that Tamaya Leck, if you know what I mean.
C-
Kitty roll a leadership roll? I don't know if I'm. Am I taking over that aspect of that character?
For now, I think you are.
Okay,
yes, you are.
Fair enough.
Yeah. Absolutely.
All right. So I'd like him to roll his leader. I'm going to use Gippy's sheet for it, but just roll his leadership roll.
Sure, that works for me.
To inspire you all to do better. And by inspire, I mean he's going to take out his remote control and be like, "All right, dude. He's like, here's a little pick me up right into your spinal column." So
yep, that's fine.
Okay, great. This is going to give you guys a boost die.
Got it.
And so this is not necessarily to switch their brains, but just to
just a little bit, just a little bit of dopamine straight to their like cerebral cortex. Let's see if that that pans out.
That's not.
It does not. It gives them an advantage.
Whoops! Wrong button, fellas.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. That was just the searing pain button.
Oh no!
But yeah, right. I suppose that motivates you just as much.
Searing pain down your arms. It does not really. But he does. He does make it clear that he needs access to all of your quarters, all of your. You don't really have personal belongings necessarily. They're all belongings to the state at this point, and.
This is a really sucky republic.
You guys.
I just have
that's
to say.
Democracy for you.
Is that technically
things
how
changed
we're
really quick under the Trump administration? Executive power is a hell of a thing.
Okay, listen, just don't touch my posters.
For sure, they're like, oh, no, touch the posters, huh? Well, you hiding secret messages from Tamaya?
No, I drew those myself.
Droids, go in there and tear all those posters down so we can have a look at them. They march in, reach up to grab your posters. Oh, how much of an asshole am I?
I give a glance over to Yerp. Mm-hmm.
That says what?
whatever rip goes into my posters, goes into them. It's attack time!
Yerp comes charging forward. P9K, turns around, gun up. Brain course powers into him. Go ahead and make an attack roll.
A thrilling conclusion to the story arc.
Yeah. Oh, I gotta think. Oh, okay. Hey, just in time. Forsaken activates Yerp's bloodlust.
Oh. Wait, what?
That was the donation that you suggested.
Yeah, yeah.
Is he goes?
So he's the bonus, right?
He's gonna berserker out. Yeah. So I think we set a boost die for a bonus for sure on everything.
Mm-hmm.
And just two purple against this attack roll, but I think it also means it's gonna be hard to get him back under control.
Yeah, definitely. Mm. He's just gonna berserk until all these droids are dead.
Which is too bad because the droids are in your room, and that's what he's charging into.
He knows not to touch those posters.
Yeah.
He knows.
Nope.
Mm. Oh.
That's
tons of success.
Tons of success.
My God, actually.
I think that psychic link is coming in handy.
It sure is.
Success. And the threat and that.
What was the poster that you drew yourself? What was the poster of?
It's my favorite Ewok musician from back when I was at home.
That's so cute.
So.
He was like really good on the sticks, hitting sticks together.
Yeah,
thing.
Yeah. So he's holding some sticks in some trees.
Real basic drawing.
I'm not a good artist.
I'm thinking
so it's
crayon.
Like 100%. It's crayon held in a fist.
So the Ewok's like big circle face, circle body,
Circle eyes.
Oh my God.
Really, that's nothing that anyone reasonable would protect.
but
some people are about to die.
Ready to give that kill command. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
All right.
Yeah. This is three success and an advantage.
Wow, how much damage does Yerp do?
Yerp does 8 and crits at 3.
Great. Wham! Yerp comes slamming in. P9K is
Pierce of 2 as well.
Oh, Pierce of 2. It goes flying back against like the back wall as one of its arms just like flies off and the gun hits the ground. P9M stands and like turns and gets the gun ready. Fire back, but Yerp clearly has this one under control.
Oh, yeah.
However, he's rampaging out of control in your little room.
Yeah.
Would you go in to keep it under control, or would you stand back and be like,
I'm going
to
pull out my slingshot and wing some at this other piece of crap.
So this escalated extremely quickly for the rest of you. You guys are like, oh, okay. This does, and then Rancor out of control, slam into the thing. What would the sergeant be doing if that sort of thing happened?
He'd be frantically getting his remote out and just be like, doo, 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 doo,
oh,
doo,
no.
Doo.
Okay.
So I don't know what effect that has.
That's great. Okay, so as you're getting ready to hit these buttons and switch everybody over, that beeping is suddenly cut off by, you're in the pilot seat?
Yes.
Doodle-doo-doo-doo-doo. Which is incoming message. Doodle-doo-doo-doo. Doodle-doo-doo-doo. A little message like going.